We waited long time for this event to happen, and now here it is. First European Championship FAI F5J, Bulgaria, Dubnica. Day 1, afternoon, very windy day. And most of it we spent grounded, waiting for the winds to decrease a bit. So seniors are now flying, probably their last round for this day. And the wind is still quite strong. There really isn't much thermaling to do. You just fly straight into the wind, hang there, wait for the time to pass, and hope you get as much flying out of it as possible. This is my first time here in Bulgaria. As you can see, the place is situated in a valley with hills all around. And the interesting thing is that this valley is about 900 meters above sea level, which is higher than what most of us are used to in practice flights. And this altitude affects handling characteristics of the planes, of course. The air is a bit thinner, so the planes fly a bit faster. And this comes into effect on landing, especially with the timing. But this is not as critical, since we have high winds, and this is what determines the landing. Again, it's good result already if you manage to come back to land. If you just end up within 75 meters, that's already good, because people still land far outside of the 75 meters. So it turns out that all the latest fashion of flight models is working against the pilots here, and all of the planes we see in the air are either the older ones or filled with ballast to max capacity. So the winds here are reaching 10 meters per second occasionally, so after the lunch break we were even holding down the tents to prevent them from flying away. And see, I just made one circle a couple of minutes and the planes are already above me and really low. There's even one guy behind me, okay. I'm not too much of an obstacle, I hope. We have cows passing by each morning and each afternoon. Okay, this one didn't flip over. We've seen some really bad landings and models damaged on the landing. I think this is Jan Hlastec. He had a reasonably good flight in the previous round as well. There are still some people flying. There's at least one more plane behind me. Let's see if he makes it to the point. Barely. But he's within 75 meters, so he will get the points. So this is an impression of day one in Dubnica, Bulgaria. Two minutes to go and everybody's on the ground already. Day two, still windy, but a bit less than yesterday. Still, it makes for a challenging flying. This is one of the junior rounds. As you can see, there's no one going low, because there's no point in going low if you want to make a good result. So what usually happens, or what we are seeing today, is that planes spread around evenly into the wind, upwind, and then they just mostly hang there. Only when there is a really good sign of good rising air, they start to turn downwind. But then again, they have to be sure to be able to come back. We've seen some senior pilots turning downwind immediately, and I think few of them even managed to make a full time out of that strategy, and each time they were awarded with loud applause from the public. Finally, they're now starting to come towards me. At least one of them is really low. But he is giving up apparently. Safer choice for me. Another interesting observation is that we still see classical models flying with ribs and aura cover. Where's the rest of the crowd now? Into the sun, I guess. So four planes managed to catch this thermal and are now fighting to have enough height to enable them to return. This could be interesting. Now they're starting to come back. I heard that there's only 2 minutes remaining. And I don't really see what I'm looking at. Like a Murphy's Law, there's always a thermal in the sun. Well done, juniors. Day 3, before noon. Much less wind than the previous 2 days, but still there's enough wind from a different direction than the previous 2 days. And we have launches in the other direction. So the wind is now blowing in my back, which makes it a southwesterly direction. And most of the flying is happening above the camp actually. still the conditions are not so easy as one might expect in this weather. And as you can see, no one started low. I guess this has to do with the fact that the air here is really dry. It's over 30 degrees and I'm basically not sweating at all. And since the air is dry, the thermals that are here are also very weak. This is one of the junior rounds. Round 6, group 2, if I heard correctly. And I have no reference on the background with some clouds, so it's very difficult to catch any planes. There's a group of 3. All really high away. I'll just try to get the landings. Two minutes to go. Well done, Junior. Not 10 minutes after the previous shot, the wind picked up, and now we again have the same wind as yesterday. It's now past 3 p.m. and seniors are continuing to fight this wind. Previous group didn't do all that well. Let's see what this group will do. So we see delayed starts. It's a strategy to see how the others are doing. Before you start. There's now one group over the middle of the field. And another one to the left, behind the camp. And as you can see, the flags are pretty active. So the contest director tent gave up on day one and is now more or less flat with the hole in the middle. So as far as I can see, all of them are losing height pretty fast. And there's not really much that you can do. Another late start. And another late start. That guy over there, I think, is already too far to come back. Although he has all the chance to turn to the point earlier. So he might just make it to within 75 meters. That's about 50 meters now, I guess. In the meantime, three more planes are down. They all got to the point. So what's happening over the camp now? Some people are trying to ride the wave of the camp. Looks like it's working for some, but not for all. There's one really, really high. So someone did manage to find the terminal. Others not so much. Really strong gust of wind now. Two more successful landings. Who's the last one flying? I think these are the guys from Ukraine. I took a peek at the score sheets and it's really quite amazing. The guy on the number one position has only one bad flight, and then all the way down to the ninth position I think there are people with at least two bad flights, and down to 12th position people have three bad flights. And since only 12 people will go to the flyoffs, it's quite amazing that you can reach a flyoff at a major competition with three bad flights. This gives you some idea about the conditions we have here. They are still looking straight up and they have 2 minutes to go, which tells me they are still pretty high. I didn't follow his start, but I've seen some people doing starts at 250 meters or even higher. It's the only way to make a full time of 10 minutes. But if you go to 300 meters, it still doesn't make sense since you only get like 200 or 300 points at the end. This is quite typical here. Empty flight line, just some timekeepers and a lonely pilot with his helper. but he's now close already, coming down. Just trying to nail the landing. Very good. And applause. He certainly deserved it. Let's see what this group will do. Three are still waiting. Two. As far as I can tell, there's only one to my right, and the rest of them are all far in the distance. Straight ahead and slightly to the left. They will all far upwind, but the wind has already blown them over the line. They are now fighting for their last minutes over the camp. And this is all that's possible to do here. one is now right above me. Bad landing. But still, there's one that stayed up. And this is making huge differences in the scoring. So as you can imagine, all these planes are loaded with the ballast to the max. But still they're flying backwards, as you can see. There's another one closer to me. So looks like two people managed to stay in the air almost till the end. Very good. That's not even 8 minutes into the flight. Still plenty of time left. Everyone on the ground. This was now the sign for the 2 minutes remaining. And this is quite typical of the windy Dubnica flying. Adding more ballast while another group is starting. Again, majority is left in front of camp, while there's one solo flyer on the right side of the starting line. There's now a bird with that group. Let's see if it brings them any help, any luck, but just passing through the group. So no thermal there, even worth a single turn for a bird. Yet I see some people doing circles there. I don't think that circling here is the smartest choice. What I would do is conserve energy as much as possible and just stay still. So the last hope for the guys on the left side is that tree behind the camp. There's supposedly a wave coming off of it, and some people are trying to make use of it. It's not working for this guy this time. Looks like now the right side was better choice. That was close. And the last one. Too late. It's now almost 7 p.m. and juniors are flying their last group. As you can see, sun is covered by clouds and we are in the shadow. So it's now very obvious that there will be no thermals whatsoever. It kind of makes sense to wait a bit on the start, see what's happening in the air. Oh yeah, someone lost a prop apparently. And the last two in the air. As you can see, there's not much to do really. Just hang in the air, conserve your energy and hope that you're in a relatively good air compared to the others, which is a lottery really. There are absolutely no signs about the air, no birds, nothing. So even the best pilots have problems. Is it? Sun is getting low, shadows are getting long. And turns out I was wrong, and this is now the last group of the juniors for today. Very strong gust of wind now. Thank you. So this was it for day 3.